Good afternoon, children. I am Srishel. Welcome to the social science class. So let us continue the previous class, right? So yesterday the thing which we were discussing about what happened, children, what, when, where and how, this is our first chapter. In that first chapter, some of the points we have already discussed, those are the areas where women and men first began to grow the crops, which as a wheat and barley was about 8000 years ago. So what happened, children, here from now the 8000 years ago, what happens? First time the men and women both together, they have started the growing the wheat and barley, right? First time they have got how to do this agriculture farming, right? So next, what happened, children? The second points we have discussed, the people also began to look after the animals like sheep, goat, cattle, and used to live in the villages. Then after that, what the people has learned, children, they have started how to utilize the animals. This is called as cattle, like sheep, goat, right? Then the whatever the buffaloes, ox, cows we people are keeping, right? For what purpose they were keeping? For the milk purpose, right? For the uses of these are the animals they used to keep. Then they were staying in the particular villages, the group of the area. They have made it the village and they were staying, right? So next point, the areas where the people also began to look after the animals like sheep, goat, cattle, and used to live in the village. The places where rice was first grown are to the north of Vindhyas. So yesterday what I have discussed, children, so this is our east and this is our west and this is north and this is south, right? So what happens here, the first time the wheat and barley, first time they have started growing here, the men and women together, right? So what happens, they have started the living in the villages and here. So whatever yesterday we have discussed, Vindhyas, right? So the place where the rice first grown are the north of the Vindhyas, right? So in this place, the Vindhyas, the hills are locating in this place. First time what they have started, children, they have started growing first time wheat, right? So in Indian history, right? Then what happened, children, Vindhyas? So about 2500 years ago, what happens, about 2500 years ago, the cities developed on the bank of the Ganga and its tributaries along with the sea coasts. So what happens, from the present 2500 years ago, what happened, children? So people already, they were aware of the doing agriculture. Then they were much aware of this cattle, in the sense the keeping animals with them, right? Even they have started living in the small villages in the group of the people. After what they have done, they used to be made their their homes or their group of the people, they used to be in the near the water bodies. As like yesterday I told you, the Ganga and its tributaries, right? The Ganga is a main river, and so many like Yamuna, the many of the tributaries to reaches to the main river, right? So what happens, all the people, they used to make a group, then they used to be there in the near the banks of the river because of the water. They need the water, is a needful thing, so they need to get it the water from the river, right? So what happens, all these small villages, it has no growing like cities. Now what happens, children? So people, they were staying in the group of the village, then so many villages together, it has become the city. Now this is the growing of the cities, right? So the cities got developed on the banks of the river of Ganga and its tributaries. In the sense, what, children? We can say from this point, the first time cities has developed in the area of the Ganga and its tributaries, river Ganga and its tributaries area, right, along the sea coast, right. So in ancient time, the area along the Ganga and its tributaries to the south of the Ganga known as the Magadha. So here there is a, you know, particular nestle. So what happened? So children, as you know, in India is the habitat of so many rivers. Among the so many rivers, the Ganga is the largest one, right? So Ganga is the one of the among the largest, one of the river. So it has so many rivers, right? It's continuously 12 years it is flowing through the year. So what happens first time? So people, they have started bigger to leave the bank of the river of the Ganga, right? So what happens in this area? So in India, what happens first time? So Ganga, it is flowing, so many tributaries are gathering here, right? So in this particular area, first time small villages has begun. From these villages, the city, they were developing. There were so many, the cities have got developed here, the banks of the rivers. So this place is called, right? So this place is called Magadha. So there was an empire. So after these cities, from the developing of the cities, what it has begun, children? It has begun as a, the empire. Which empire, children? The Magadha Empire. Right? So then where the first time the Magadha Empire has, the established, children? The river bank of the Ganga and its tributaries. Right? So Magadha Empire, which is now laying in Bihar. So if you ask me, children, so in which state the Magadha Empire is locating, lying? So it is located in the Bihar. Nowadays, whatever the place is there, so the place which we are discussing, so that place is, now it is locating in the state of Bihar. So the Bihar old name is Magadha, we can say, right? So which is Bihar. The men and women moved to search of livelihood and also the escape from the natural distracts like flood or droughts. So what happened, children? First of all, I say, so the people, they used to make a groups, then they used to be in the near the banks, then it has developed as a villages, then the villages has got developed as a cities. From these cities, the establishment of the Magadha Empire, right? So in the Magadha Empire, what happens? So many people, they used to migrate one place to another place, right? So they used to move to one place to another place because of their livelihood, right? So if you think, children, I have a work in Mahalingpur or Mudod, right? So I can stay in Mudod. If I don't have any work in the Mudod, in that sense, what are the reasons I must say here, right? So I move from this place to another place. The same thing is going on. So many people from this Magadha Empire, during this time, they used to move one place to another place, right? For what reason? So men and women, they move to search for their livelihood. If they need the occupation, if they are not having any kind of occupation work to get the money, they used to move one place to another place. And also escape from the natural distress. So what happens here? If any kind of the natural issues, what kind of a natural issues? Flood, right? First, let me explain what is flood. Flood in the sense, suddenly water overflow from the rivers, right? At night, if the bank of the rivers, so many villages are established nowadays. If suddenly the water overflow from the rivers, what will happen, children? So complete village is going to, be in the water. So this is the what situation called as flood, right? So overcoming of the water. So many times during this time, what happened, children? So water will overflow from the rivers. So many people, they were dying due to this flood. So for this reason, what happens? They need to move from this place to another place, right? So another one natural issues, that is droughts. Droughts in the sense what, children? From so many years, if there is no rain, right? So everywhere if we people are getting the rain, then we can get the waters from the, you know, this well, otherwise, you know, from the rivers, wherever. But if there is no rain over the places, then it is very difficult to, you know, stay alive. For this reason, what happened, children? So many people from this natural issues like floods and droughts, they used to move from one place to another place, right? So next often, so these movements of the people, they enriched our culture traditions. So what happened, children? If our family is moving because of the flood from this place to in this place, right? So you think our family is shifting from here to here in this place, we people will not move only with the empty hands, right? So whatever our vessels, whatever the clothes, whatever the property, as much as possible, we will take it and we will pack it, then we will move to the one place to another place. So it is quite common thing, right? So what happens here? These movements, the people enrich. So the people, when they were moving from one place to another place, right? So in this movement, what happens? They have brought their culture, right? So they have brought their traditions, the whatever the things they were following, right, in their earlier place. So same thing they used to bring it from one place to another place, right? So then the people have shared the new ways of, you know, carving the stone, the composing the music, and even cooking food over the several hundred years. So the matter what we people were discussing, this is, you know, 1000 years ago, right? So the 1000 years ago, right? So what happens? People, they wanted to move from one place to one place. So if they are moving, they used to take their culture, whatever they were having here. So the same culture they wanted to bring it here, right? So whatever the traditions they were following, what kind of dresses they were wearing, what kind of food they were cooking, right? So everything they need to take from this place to and this place. So here what happens, if they went to new place, even those people are having their own traditions, then their own cooking style, their own wearing style of dresses, right? So here what happens, they have shared, these people, they have shared with their tradition and their livelihood, right? So whatever, then the people, they have started learning of the molding of the stones, right? So whatever the nowadays we are using the arms to make the agriculture, right? So nowadays these, the instruments were not there. What kind of instrument they have used, children? They have used the stones, right, to cut the trees. So this is what they have started, carving, molding the stones, right? After that, the composing the music. Then after, by the time being, the people, they have started the composing the music, right? So then even the cooking food, before people, they were not knowing it, how to cook the food properly. Then after, they have learned it everything, then they have started. So this is all about, so if the people, in this point we have discussed, if the people, they have moved from one place to one place, what they need to exchange their ideas, their, the style of living, the way of cooking, the way of dressing, everything, they need to exchange their idea, and they have got exchange rate. So this is the point what we have discussed over here, right? Now we will discuss the next point, that is the names of the lands. Our next point is names of the land.
land.
So what is the meaning, children? What is the meaning of this headline? Right? So names of the land. In the sense, so all the lands, all the areas, they have their own names. Right? For example, this is Mudol. Right? So Jamakandi, you know. Even the Karnataka, India, so many names, the all the areas, they are having their own names, isn't it? So what happens here? Now in this point, let us discuss how the name the areas has got. Right? Now I will give the example. Our country is known by the both words. Right? Our country has several names, but we will take only two words here. So for example, you take the word example of India, right? So India is a name of a country. It has under one word, that is called Bharat. We can say even Hindustan, but no need. Only two things we will discuss here. So Hindustan already we have discussed. So what happened, children? Our country is known by the both words, the India and the Bharat, right? So now we will discuss how our country got the name of India, right? So the word India came from the Indus. So what is that, children? So the India word has come from the Indus, right? So from this Indus word, then after that call it as India word. The India word has come from this Indus, right? So first we should know what is Indus then, right? So India, the word, came from the Indus. Then India means what? Indus means what, right? So Indus called Sindhu. Sindhu in Sanskrit, right? So Indus means, right? So it means what? Sindhu. Right, what happened, children, here? Sindhu in the sense Indus, Indus in the sense India, right? So what is the meaning of Sindhu then? So in Sanskrit word, in Sanskrit, the word comes from the Sindhu. From the Sindhu, it has become the Indus. From the Indus, the Indian country got the name of India. So this is the history of our word India. How the India we got it, right? So what happens here? The Sanskrit, the Indians and the Greeks who came through the northwest about 2500 years ago. So what I say, children? So if you see the map of our India, right? Right? So in this map, what happened, children? So this is our northwest. So this is our northwest. So if you think here, there is a lot of waters here, water body. Then here only the land, right, which is connected to the other countries. Before discovering the sea routes to the India, so many other country people, they used to come from this land route, in the sense, in the direction of northwest. By this land route, they were coming, right? From this route, they are coming to the India, right? So what happened, children? When they were coming from the Greek, so many people from the Greek, they were coming to the India. So the who came through the northwest about 2500 years ago called it Hindus. So what they have called it, children? They have called it to the areas Hindus, right? So are the Hindus. What they were calling with the name of Hindus are Hindus, whom? The Greek people, right? And the land of the east of the river was called India, right? So whatever the, this part is there, so they have used the word for this areas, this is India, right? So this is Indus and it is India they were calling, right? By this word, the complete our nation got the word of India, right? So this is the meaning of this word India. So then I said the India has another one name, that is called Bharat. Then how the name our Bharat has got? So this is the thing, right? So the name Bharata was used for a group of people who lived in the northwest, right? So before how children? So Bharata word used only for the in this area. So how many people they were staying in this area? So those are called those areas only. Those areas were called northwest. So those areas were called Bharat. And who are the maintained the Rig Veda? So what happens here? So the people, those who are living in this particular place, those are the mentioned in Rig Veda. Actually, we have four Vedas. Those are Rig Veda, Atharvana Veda, Sama Veda, and you know, actually there are four Vedas. So among them, there is a Rig Veda is a main Veda. So in that, so what kind of a culture, what kind of a people they were staying, how they were staying, what their culture, everything has noted in the Rig Veda. So in that particular place has called Bharata, the earliest composition and Sanskrit, right? The letter it was used for the country. So first time the Bharata word has used for this area. Then after, so what happens? The Bharata is word used by for this complete word. So for these two words, no, the India got in this such a way that so people the before they were calling with other name and to the other areas. Then after what happens? The name we got it for the entire country. So this is the history of the word India and the Bharata. So today I'll conclude my teaching. Tomorrow let's continue tomorrow. Bye.